Okay, sådan, så er vi tilbage, we're back. And today we're gonna do some basic Danish vocabulary, the second one. Yes, I made one before last year, you can check that out as well. Today we're gonna have some vocabulary, mostly about clothes and accessories, stuff like that, things you carry on your person. So yeah. And that's it. And as always, I have to say, check out the website, because that is where the good stuff is. Yeah, YouTube is cool, but it's much better on the website. So check that out, danishmastery.com. All right, let's begin. Skal lige have noget vand. All right, sådan. So we got some vocab here. Toy. Toy. Tøj, clothes. Trøje. Shirt. T-shirt. Well, T-shirt is the same, eh? Just say it with a Danish accent. T-shirt. Jakke. Jacket. This is a good chance to practice the J in Danish, eh? So you don't say jakke. No. The Danish J is pronounced like an English Y. Eh? Jakke. Yeah, like that. BH. BH. Bra. BH is an acronym, abbreviation, eh? Because you would say brystholder, eh? Breast holder, literally. But we just say beho, because it's faster. Beho. Buksa. Pants. Yeah. Buksa. Underbuksa. Pants. Underwear. Well, specifically underwear, like underpants. You can also say that, of course. Underbuksa. Underpants. Trosa. Underwear. For women, right? Only for women. Trosa. Yeah. Okay, let's see what else we got. Kjole. Kjole. Dress, right? And this is a dress, not to dress. Yeah. Kjole. Shorts. Shorts is the same, right? But with a Danish accent. Shorts. Mm-hmm. Badetøj. Badetøj. Swimwear is badetøj, right? Bathing clothes, you could say, as a direct translation. Badetøj. Yeah, bikini, same, right? Bikini. Mm-hmm. Belte. A belt. Belte. Mm-hmm. Sokker, because usually it's plural, but hey, sometimes it's singular. Sokker. Socks. That's right. Sko. Shoes. Right. Sko. Sandaler. Sandals. Sandaler. Moving on. Alright. Stoler. Boots. Yeah. Stoler. And then you got sutsko. suit, sko, slippers. Yeah, the kind of stuff you wear inside, eh? To keep your feet warm. That's a kind of funny word, suit sko, because suit means pacifier, or to suck, in, like sucking on an object. So yeah, suit sko. Handsker. Gloves or mittens. It's actually both, right? Well, you say Vandyke's mittens, but yeah. Handsker. Yeah, here we have the exact one, that's mittens. Vanda. Mittens. Hat. A hat. Like just Danish accent. Slightly different. Hat. Hue or hua. Beanie hats. You know, like in South Park, the things they wear. Yeah. Hue. Hua. Casket. Casket. A cap. Right? On your head. Casket. Yeah, I know it might be funny, like, oh, it's a casket? No, it's casket. That's how you say it. Yeah. And then you got tørklæde. Scarf. Right? Tørklæde. Alright. So, if you're really learning this, you need some examples. And I wrote some stuff here, try to make it all connected so it's a little more stimulating. Alright, see what we got. Hvor har du meget tøj? Jeg er imponeret. Du har trøjer, kjoler og jakker, bukser, sokker og sko. Du mangler ikke noget. Hvad synes du om min nye t-shirt? Okay, let's do it slowly and translate. Hvor har du meget tøj? Jeg er imponeret. You have a lot of clothes, sort of like how much clothes you have, eh? I know other languages have this too, like K or something. I'm impressed. Du har trøjer, kjoler og jakker. You have shirts, dresses and jackets. Bukser, sokker og sko. Du mangler ikke noget. Pants, socks and shoes. You're not missing anything or lacking, eh? Mangler means that you don't have. So it's not missing emotionally. That is savner. Like, oh, you savner dig. Like that. Hvad synes du om min nye t-shirt? What do you think of my new t-shirt? Yeah, pretty straightforward. I'll take a second here, eh? You can learn a lot when you look at the translations here. Yeah, it's very straight. Imponeret, impressed. Trøjer, shirts, kjoler, dresses, jakker, jackets, bukser, pants, sokker, socks, sko, shoes, etc. Kinda sweet, kinda awesome. Alright, moving on. Fast speed first. Jeg købte den i går. Jeg købte også et nyt bælte. Prøv at se min nye kasket. Den er fed. Jeg kan se, du har et grønt tørklæde. Det klæder dig. Nu tager jeg vand på, fordi det er koldt. Okay, a bit slow. Jeg købte den i går. Jeg købte også et nyt bælte. I bought it yesterday. I bought a new belt too. Right? Og prøv at se min nye kasket. Den er fed. And look at my new cap. It's cool. Now, a little note here. Prøv at se is literally try and look or try to look. Right? So it doesn't have anything to do with actually trying. It's just, hey, check it out. Right? I could also say prøv at høre. Like, listen to this. Check this out. It's just how Danish is used sometimes. So yeah, it's cool. Jeg kan se, du har et grønt tørklæde på. Det klæder dig. Og klær, usually we pronounce it klær, because we're lazy. Det klæder dig, det klæder dig. I can see you are wearing a green scarf. It suits you. Yes, klæder is suits, like it matches you, it looks good on you, like that. Nu tager og tager, if you want to be very dictionary about it. Nu tager jeg venter på, fordi det er koldt. Now I'm putting on mittens, I'm putting mittens on, because it's cold. Eh? So, pretty straightforward, pretty easy. Let's take another look here, some of this stuff. Jeg købte den, I bought it. Købte, bought again. Et nyt bælte, a new belt. Prøv at se, like, look at. Kasket, cap. Fed, cool. Oh yeah, I forgot to comment on this before, but yeah, fed is like our standard word for something that's cool or awesome or sweet, or you're like, oh, that is so fed, it's so cool. Like, most people use it. And yes, fed also means fat, and so be careful you say to a person, oh, du er så fed, and it's like, you're really fat. Be careful. Grønt tørklæde, green scarf, det klæder, venter, mittens. Yes, golden vocabulary. Now we move on. Du har en hue på. Den er sort. Sort, ligesom min shorts. God stil. Vi har begge sutsko på, selvfølgelig. Men af en eller anden grund har din kat sandaler på. This is so stupid. This is really, really stupid shit. But hey, it's good for learning Danish. Du har en hue på. Den er sort. You're wearing a beanie hat. It's black. Like, so let's focus here for a second. Du har something something på is you're wearing. And like you have it on, literally. Hvad har du på? What are you wearing? Like, in Danish, there are many words for getting dressed or wearing. It can be a little bit complicated. Maybe one day I'll elaborate. But yeah, this is a standard way. If you're wearing it right now, you could say, jeg har something something på. Hvad har du på? Etc. Etc. Just like that. Yeah. Hue. And it is winter now, so yeah. Who's cool? Remember the hat. Sort. Ligesom mine shorts. God stil. Black. Just like my shorts. Cool or good style. Ah, okay, okay. So, gotta elaborate here because, yeah, ligesom is just like. And that's pretty simple. But god stil is, yeah, I know you don't say good style in English like that. But if you say god stil, it can mean different things. It can be an actual style, like the way someone is dressed. But it can also be something that's sort of respectable or something you admire and go like, oh, nice one, mate. And go, good move, kind of like that. Go steal. So it's in colloquial, what the hell is that? Colloquial, informal Danish. Eh? This is what you can say to people, you know. You wouldn't say it to the queen, but then again, you're not going to meet the queen. And it would also be a bit unexpected if you said it in Rema or Netto when you're shopping. Eh? But with friends, sure, you can say, god stil, eh? Conversely, you could also say, dårlig stil, which is kind of like, oh, that's kind of lame, like, that's not cool, why are you doing that, eh? Dårlig stil. Maybe someone who's, I don't know, coughing all over in the bus, that would be dårlig stil, for example. So, moving on. Vi har begge sutsko på, selvfølgelig. We're both wearing slippers, of course. Okay. Yeah, nothing to add. Men af en eller anden grund har din kat sandaler på. But for some reason, your cat is wearing sandals. Yeah. What to say here? Well, what I have to say is af en eller anden grund, and for some reason. En eller anden, I think I talked about this before. It's kind of like for some reason that is unknown, and for one or another reason, like en eller anden grund. It's when something is unclear or not identified, then you could say en eller anden or et eller andet, eh? Depending on the noun that follows. En eller anden grund, for some reason, some unknown reason. And then, of course, the cat is wearing sandals, like they always do. Okay, cool. Moving on. So, here we got some new vocabulary, and this is most like accessories or anything that you would have in your pockets or your bag, right? Very useful stuff. So, den første ring. 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 Right? Ring. Ring, ring, ring. Ring is here, Lord of the Rings. Halskæde. Halskæde. Necklace. Ja. Halskæde. Armbånd. Armbånd. Bracelet. Armbånd. Briller. Briller. My bad, of course, it's just glasses. Ignore this son. This son of a bitch right here. Right. Just glasses. Briller. Glasses. Solbriller. Solbriller. Sunglasses. Øreringe og ørering. Øreringe. Earrings. Ur. Ur. Watch. One you wear, I think. Ur. Telefon. Telefon. Telephone. Phone. Telefon. Mobiltelefon. Mobiltelefon. Cell phone. I know nowadays it seems redundant to say that because most people only have cell phones, but yeah, this is the exact word, right? Mobile phone. Mobil telefon. Pung. Pung. Wallet. Yeah. Pung. Kort. Kort. Sounds so serious when I say it. Card, like any kind of card. Your credit card, health insurance card, playing cards, pretty much any card, eh? Kort. Kort, kort, kort. Pass. Pass. Passport. Pass. Penge. Penge. Money. Penge. Kontanter. Kontanter. Cash. Ja. Kontanter. Mønter. Og mønter. Mønter. Coins. You probably noticed that in Danish, a lot of the time we don't say the T. And that can be a bit annoying, but you'll get used to it when you live in Denmark. You're like, oh yeah, don't say the T. Pronounce it more like a D, I think. Ah, ja, så mange mønter. Ja, mønter. Almost overpronounced, right? That's why you gotta watch videos, but you also gotta listen to people in real life, because they talk fast. Sedler. Sedler. Sedler is notes or bills, and paper money. Sedler. Okay. And some more vocab. Nøgle. Nøgle. Key. Right? Any kind of key. Nøgle. Nøglering. Nøglering. Keyring or keychain. Nøglering. Læbepomade. Og læbepomade. Often we are too lazy to say the E at the end. Læbepomade. Lip balm. Læbepomade. Læbepomade. Læbestift. Læbestift. Lipstick. Læbestift. Tyggegummi. tyggegummi, if you want to say it fast. Tyggegummi. Chewing gum. Chewing gum. Bubble gum. Tyggegummi. Parfume. Parfume. Perfume. Perfume. Parfume. Serviette. Serviette. Tissue. Taske. Taske. Back. Yep, kind of back you can have something in. Yeah, it's taske. Alright, and then, yes, we have some examples. Let's see. Jeg har fundet en ring. Den lå i min taske. Den lå under nogle gamle mønter. Jeg fandt også en pakke tyggegummi. Lækkert. Men jeg kan ikke finde min nøgle. Det er ikke så godt. Alright, let's do it slowly and translate. Jeg har fundet en ring. Den lå i min taske. I found a ring. It was lying in my bag. Lå is like lie or lying. So it was under. Well, that's the next one. But it was in the bag. Den lå under nogle gamle mønter. It was lying under some old coins. Yeah, pretty straightforward. Gamle mønter, old coins. Right? Nothing to add there. Jeg fandt også en pakke tyggegummi. Lækkert. I also found a pack of chewing gum. Sweet. Jeg skal lige have noget vand. Alright, so... the thing here is that lækkert is... I mean, most of you might know that lækker means delicious about food or sexy slash hot about a person. But you can also say it if something is convenient, like neat. Well, that's kind of sweet. Oh, yeah, not bad. Found some money. Right? Or chewing gum in this case. So, yeah, lækker or lækkert can be used in different ways. So you have to pay attention to the context. Yeah. Ah, lækkert. Nice. Sweet. Men jeg kan ikke finde min nøgle. Det er ikke så godt. But I can't find my key. That's not so good. That's pretty straightforward. Ik? Kan ikke finde. Cannot find. Min nøgle. My key. Det er ikke så godt. That's not so good. Yeah. Alright, we move on. Hvorfor kigger du på mit ur? Vil du stjæle det? Nå, det er mine penge, du vil stjæle. Nu kaster jeg min læbestift efter dig. Hvad siger du så? Hov, du har taget min pung. Kom tilbage. Again, very, very silly. But let's take a look here. Hvorfor kigger du på mit ur? Vil du stjæle det? Why are you looking at my watch? Do you want to steal it? Straightforward. Nå, det er mine penge. Du vil stjæle. Oh, it's my money you want to steal. So this nå, if you're already in Denmark, you might be like, ah, this nå has so many meanings. And yeah, it does. Right? But here is like a surprise and a bit of a conclusion. Nå, oh, it's my money. Nå, det er mine penge. Right? Nå. But it could also be like, nå, nå, nå. Nå. Like different ways of saying it. There are many. Det er mine penge, du vil stjæle. Nu kaster jeg min læbestift efter dig. Hvad siger du så? Now I'm throwing my lipstick at you. How about that? So yeah, kaster is, well, throwing, it's a throw here. Because, you know, like cast, think Chromecast or something like that. So yeah, læbestift, lipstick. And this one, hvad siger du så, is kind of interesting because the literal translation would be, what do you say then? But it's more like, how about that, huh? I did this, what are you gonna do? What's your comment? What do you think about that? Hvad siger du så? So it depends on the context, but usually if you say, or if you hear someone say, hvad siger du så, it's kind of like they want some feedback, or they expect a response. Hvad siger du så? But it's weird if you say it all the time. It sounds very, I don't know, like you're looking for attention, eh? So don't do that. But once in a while, it's cool. Vesirosa. Kind of like that. Ho. Ho, 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 ho. Ho, du har taget min pung. Kom tilbage. Oh, taken my wallet. Come back. Now, this one, ho, is always a little difficult to translate, but ho is usually when something is a surprise. More on the negative side. And like, oh, that's not cool. That's not right. Ho, it's not supposed to be that way. Like, ho. It doesn't have to be that extreme. Could also be a mind thing. Ho, right? But yeah, there is a surprise and a little bit of, it's not right, right? Kind of build into it. So yeah. Du har taget min pung, kom tilbage, come back. And this is, of course, very dramatic. In real life, I don't know if they would say that. It's doubtful. But then again, we don't have so much crime in Denmark. No. Næste. Jeg har tabt mit kort på jorden. Jeg må hellere samle det op. Jeg taber altid ting. I sidste uge var det mit pas. Lidt klodset er jeg måske. Nå, hvor er min parfume? Jeg vil gerne dufte godt. Og hvor er min telefon? Okay, so this person is very clumsy. Jeg har tabt mit kort på jorden. Jeg må hellere samle det op. I dropped my card on the ground. I better pick it up. So, har tabt is dropped. And now, a little note here. Tabt, or, you know, it comes from tabe. Tabe means to lose, and like a bet or a match or anything. Like that. But it's also to drop, and like drop something on the floor or the ground. So, yeah. Jeg må hellere. This is really good. Jeg må hellere is like I better. And hellere means I rather, like jeg vil hellere. But if you say jeg må hellere, then it's like I better do. This is the wise thing to do. Right? Super useful. Samle det up, pick it up. Alright. Jeg taber altid ting. Sidste uge var det mit pas. I always drop things. Last week was my passport. Right? So kind of same thing here. Taber altid ting, always drop things. Sidste uge var det mit pas. Yeah, okay, nothing to add here. Lidt klodset er jeg måske. Nå, hvor er min parfume? A bit clumsy, maybe I am. Well, where's my perfume? Perfume, I can never get that right. So, yeah, this is hard to translate. Literally, it's like, a little clumsy, maybe I am, or I am maybe. Like, so, er jeg måske? There is an inversion here. Lidt klodset er jeg måske. I could also say, jeg er måske lidt klodset. Eh? That would also be fine. Nå. And here it is again. Nå. But this one is like, well, nå. Hvor er den? Well, where is it? Eh? Kind of like moving on or changing the topic. Nå. Hvor er den? Hvor er min parfume? Jeg vil gerne dufte godt. Og hvor? Er min telefon. I want to smell good. And where is my phone? Now, of course, dufte is the positive one. Eh? You have lugte. L-U-G-T-E. Lugte is more, it's neutral to negative. Eh? But dufte is always positive. So I want to smell good. Eh? I could just say dufte. Even dufte on its own means smell good. But I would like to emphasize with God here. Og hvor er min telefon? And where is my phone? Just like that. Alright, we move on. Ay, 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 ay. Up too far. No, you naughty computer. Here we go. There we go. Jeg skal ringe til min onkel. Han har min læbe på mad. Ja, det er vel lidt mærkeligt. Jeg ved det godt. Han siger, han vil have min nøglering. Den er faktisk lidt grim, så det er okay med mig. Det er okay med mig. Let's see here. Jeg skal ringe til min onkel. Han har min læbe på mad. I have to call my uncle. He has my lip balm. yeah, not much to say here. Skal is just I have to. I must. Jeg skal ringe til. I have to call whoever you're calling. Ja, det er vel lidt mærkeligt. Jeg ved det godt. Yeah, I guess it is a bit strange. I know. So, vel is like the Danish version of I guess. Right? So, don't say something like, jeg gætter, at det er mærkeligt. Jeg gætter på, at det er mærkeligt. No, no, no. Vel, right? That is all you gotta say. So, it's an adverb. Det er vel lidt mærkeligt. I guess it is a bit strange. Mm-hmm. Han siger, han vil have min nøglering. He says he wants my key ring, keychain. Okay, fair enough. So, han vil have is he wants. If you want to do something, then you just say, jeg vil, and then the verb. So, like, jeg vil spise, I want to eat, jeg vil løbe, I want to run. But if you want to have something, you have to say, jeg vil have. I know in English you don't have to say, I want to have, whatever. But in Danish, you kind of do. You can say, jeg vil min nøglering. That's, no, that's weird. Gotta do it right. And then the last one. Den er faktisk lidt grim, så det er okay med mig. It's actually kind of ugly, so that's okay with me. Right? Now, this is very straight, and the translation here, there's almost nothing to add. Faktisk, actually, grim, ugly, okay med mig, okay with me. Right? So, yeah. That was the last one. Of course, there's much, much more vocabulary to cover, but we do it a little bit at a time. So, I want to say thank you. And as always, as I say in every video, you can become a member of the channel and then you get access to all these super cool videos that you don't get for free. So it's definitely worth it. It's definitely a cool investment, I would say. And also this month specifically, if you become a member of the YouTube channel, you get access to this ebook that I wrote some years ago, The Ultimate Danish Phrasebook. So it's really good. You get tons of phrases. And yeah, there's even some illustrations in there to make it colorful. So you can get that if you become a member or if you just buy the videos on the website. Right? As you can see here, if you buy the all videos deluxe or deluxe package on the website, you also get access. And of course, on the website, that is lifetime access, right? To all the videos. So some of the videos, I mean, there's like 370-something, so I can just show you a few here. I got some more advanced videos, some videos that you've never seen on YouTube. So yeah, it's a lot of good stuff. Also some more basic stuff. Yeah, all kinds, like all the way back to 2013. It's really a lot. So yeah, here you can see the three packages. And you got the basic videos, so this is like if you're a beginner, you know, you're not so sure if you're serious about Danish, but you want to help yourself a little bit, so you got that, like basic videos here. You got most videos, so this is like the vast majority of the videos, but it's not all the videos, as you can see, it stopped at 340, so since April this year, 2021, no new videos have been added here, but in this one, all videos deluxe, you got all the videos, eh? So all the videos that I ever made and ever will make, they go in here. Plus you get some bonuses, you can see. You get some bonuses here, and there's some WhatsApp group you can join. You get some PDF exercises, little PDFs you can read, a couple of podcast episodes. And as I mentioned before, you get the ebook, eh? So it's a pretty sweet deal, I would say. Yeah. All right. I think I said it all. Now I have to check the live chat. We got one from Saren Tesfalem Kirane, letter S song. Yeah, I'm sorry, I don't know what that is. Is that a children's song? And Benomhani Bilal says, hello, hello. And again, you say, tak skal du have. I think you mean, tak skal du have. Yeah, tak, thank you. All right, guys, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Well, it's Saturday. I gotta head out because it's time for No Way Home. All right, so I'll see you soon. Bye.